Have you ever met Mike Tyson?
Yeah.
What was that like?
I think it was before the Klitschko fight. He comes into me, he's like, man, I just came here to wish you good luck.
I'm
like, man, you can go in for Klitschko. Why are you telling me good luck? And he shook my hand. Big fucking banana hands.
His
feet. Squeezed hard as fuck. Yeah, his feet are awkwardly
his
fucking
feet
huge.
Are like this.
Yeah. Like if you push him, he's gonna go like this. But dude, you can just tell, yeah, huge hands, like a normal.
Would you want to fight him next?
When you do exhibitions now. When you see Mike Tyson, you understand exactly why.
Yeah, he's just he is abnormally fucking
freak of nature, but
yeah,
cool dude though.
Very nice.
At least he came to wish you good luck. Did he laugh when you told him you're going for my opponent?
No, he kind of got mad and squeezed my hand. He has big hands. So I'm like, oh shit, I gotta fight.
All I know is Tyson Fury said that he would beat Andy Ruiz with one hand tied behind his back. I'd love to see that. I don't think he beats Andy with two good hands.
No. And depends which Andy man you're talking about too.
Yeah. I don't think Tyson Fury beats you either, Chris.
He's a good fighter.
He's a good fighter, but you saw what Otto Wallen did.
Yeah.
You're not Otto Wallen.
Oh yeah, I get you. You'd be so mad.
But listen, Mexican fans are the best fans. They're very loyal. They tune in, they come out, and for this fight, they will come in numbers, and they will tune in. You know what? No judges needed. That could be the slogan of this fight, Chris.
Thanks.
It's
yeah,
not going
to be in Texas.
Yeah?
In Texas. It's the only place that has someone big enough to hold everybody else, unless the Coliseum.
Yep.
But Chris, you didn't like Jake Paul's knockout?
Nice.
Over Nate?
So what?
It was cool?
So what? So what? What does that prove?
He's
that you could knock out a basketball player? So what?
He did his thing.
So what?
It's
a fucking basketball player, bro. It's a basketball player. You're gonna say you're the shit because you knocked out a basketball player? Fucking loser.
He's 2-0. It's just starting his career.
I get it, but you saying you knocked out a basketball player and you're fucking the shit? No, that doesn't mean shit.
It was a nice knockout.
You could put a kid that has 10 amateur fights and put in a fucking garbage man with them, he'll do the same thing. Put in a basketball player with a guy that has 10 amateur fights, he'll do the same thing. So you can't get out of here with that shit. Only dummies are gonna fucking fall for that. Come on, you knocked out a basketball player. Knock out a real boxer, then I'll give you some props.
Who do you want to see him fight?
I don't care.
How about him and McGregor, who would win?
McGregor, bro. He's a real fighter. That's disrespectful.
That's disrespectful.
To McGregor, it's very disrespectful. It's disrespectful for Mayweather, too. I think Mayweather is a dick for... He better knock the guy out.
They're supposed to fight February 20th, but I don't know if it's going to happen because we're less than a month away.
You know what? My respects go out to them because at the end of the day, they're making numbers.
Yeah, make money.
So, congratulations for you making money. It is. Congratulations. I'm not hating on that. Make that money, but don't call yourself a boxer because you knocked out a basketball player. You're a bona fide fucking tough man contest. Seriously. And then what? You fought KSY, whatever the fucking guy is. You're a boxer. The guy's a fucking other YouTube guy. Come on.
But it brings new fans, Chris. It brings new fans to the sport. It brings more exposure for eyeballs.
I don't give a shit. Honestly, I'd rather have true boxing fans than the fucking a Joe Schmo that comes out and goes, ooh, that was a good punch, he won. No, it wasn't. But again, respects go out there for making that money.
It's not easy to make money in life, so yeah.
Especially in boxing.
But I will tell you this, I've been around him, he is dedicated. He does train two or three times a day.
That's
he loves boxing.
That's all right.
He's making his
congratulations, money. Good job.
So Jonathan, if Chris Arreola does fight Andy Ruiz, how big of a fight is that?
That's huge.
That's a big pay-per-view fight. Must-see TV.
100%. You
think guys go to Mexico? I want an all-Mexican card. All-Mexican card.
I told Henry, I told Joe, fuck, we should fight in Mexico.
Yeah, you should.
And he goes,